These are the Academy voters. They are the 6,000 people who decide what wins and who loses. Oscar voters are nearly 77% male and 94% Caucasian. The Academy is broken down into different branches. You've got actors, producers, special effects, etc. Caucasians make up about 90% or more of almost every one of the 15 Academy branches, except for actors, which is only 88% white.
But the real issue here is age. The median age of an Academy voter is 62 years old. Half of them haven't made a movie in the last 2 years, and hundreds of voting members haven't made films in decades.
Back in 2011, Sony Pictures executives argued that the reason The Social Network lost to The King's Speech for Best Picture is simply because old white men don't get the Facebook.
Drop the, just Facebook.
What?
And Oscars don't come cheap either. The average cost these days to campaign for an Oscar is about $5 million. In fact, last year, the makers of Silver Linings Playbook even hired Barack Obama's deputy campaign manager to win one. Swag, soirees, smear campaigns, they're all rife, and occasionally livestock too. Yes, in 2006, director David Lynch sat on Hollywood Boulevard with a cow in order to convince people to vote for Laura Dern and her performance in Lynch's film Inland Empire.
And then, of course, there is the voting process itself, which can be a really big part of why sometimes Oscar wins can be a little bit bland.
You see, the Academy is one of the few parts of America to use preferential voting. PricewaterhouseCoopers literally print out every ballot, even if you voted online, and they stack them up according to which film people put at the top of the list. Let's say it's a close year, and this year almost definitely was, and suddenly you've got two or three major contenders. None of them have that golden 51%. So you head to the other end of the list, you take the movie with the least votes, right? What was their second preference? Bam, redistribute those votes, and then you keep on redistributing, shifting down to the second, third, fourth preferences until somebody hits that 51% mark. But here's the important thing, the reason I just made you watch 40 seconds of maths on your TV. You see this winner, only a fraction of the winning votes were from people that actually thought it was the best movie of the year. Most people thought it was second or third best. That means in order to win, you need to be the movie that most people thought was kind of okay. You needed to be a consensus win.
So if you wanted to see Julia Roberts snab an award simply to see if she had enough juice left in her tear ducts to muster a fake cry, or if you wanted to see Jonah Hill win an Oscar because the mere phrase, Jonah Hill wins an Oscar, is freaking hilarious, that is what goes into nabbing yourself an Academy Award.